Thank you. That concludes the debate on taking action on the NHS and ambulance crisis, and it's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is consideration of business motion 1328 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Moved, Presiding Officer.
Thank you. If any member wishes to contribute, please press your request to speak button now. Okay. And I call on Stephen Kerr.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I rise to speak against...
Sorry, Mr Kerr, can you just excuse me for one moment, please? Okay. Thank you, Mr Kerr. If you could just bear with me, we're going to hear from Mr Bibby first. Thank you. Neil Bibby.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I wish to move an amendment to the business motion requiring a ministerial statement to take place on COVID vaccination certificates. This is something Scottish Labour requested at the Parliamentary Bureau both last week and this week. Parliament voted for certification after the Scottish Government brought forward a debate, but did so before the Government could set out how the scheme would be implemented. The Government rightly saw the importance of debating the principle of the certification in Parliament. We didn't support the Government's proposals, but it's equally important now that there's proper and full scrutiny of the Government's implementation of this in the Chamber. The First Minister's COVID updates are on a range of issues, and we need dedicated time so members can raise the many questions they have about the implementation of this scheme. Many sectors of the Scottish economy have questions they want us to raise on their behalf. Indeed, we learned today that the Nighttime Industries Association are launching a legal challenge. This scheme will have a massive impact on businesses and workers and will go live at the end of next week. We need a statement because there are still too many unanswered questions. For example, where is the economic impact assessment? Will one be carried out? Further questions about what is a nightclub and what isn't. Detailed questions for venues that don't normally have door staff about how and when enforcement is carried out. I wouldn't expect the Minister for Parliamentary Business to be able to answer these questions now. That's why we need a dedicated ministerial statement or another debate, if the Government want one, in this chamber to address the many outstanding concerns our constituents have. I move the amendment.
Thank you. I call Stephen Kerr.
Thank you again, Presiding Officer, after a false start. I rise to speak against today's business motion. The proposed programme does not include a further debate on the details of the Scottish Government's shambolic vaccination certification plans. While we will support Neil Bibby's amendment, we still believe the final business motion, if amended, falls short of an adequate level of scrutiny. And members really should need no reminder. It is the business of Parliament to scrutinise the Executive. Presiding Officer, after weeks of the Deputy First Minister dodging questions on the definition of a nightclub, the First Minister yesterday believed she'd clarified the matter. In fact, her definition raised more questions than it answered. Dr Liz Cameron, Chief Executive of the Scottish Chambers of Commerce, said the government's new definition will result in thousands of businesses being caught up in vaccine certification rules with little time left to understand, plan and implement. She said the Scottish Government were now going beyond what was initially proposed. Each time the Deputy First Minister dodged the question, it was Scottish businesses who lost out. Each time an SNP backbencher read a Google definition of a nightclub in what I'm sure they thought was a clever debate rebuttal, it added to the confusion for Scottish businesses. And now, with the First Minister's new definition, thousands of business owners are despairing at being included in the category of nightclub, despite being nothing of the sort. There is confusion, genuine confusion. The First Minister may assume a certain level of intelligence among those she speaks to, but I, for one, would rather the government explained itself rather than suggest that those who do not understand are simply stupid. I hear there is now a legal challenge being mounted. Presiding Officer, we must have more time to properly scrutinise these proposals in a meaningful way. The business motion does not allocate time to do so, and that is why we will be opposing it at decision time.
Thank you. I now call on George Adam to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Initially, when I took on the role of Minister for Parliamentary Business, I vowed that I would be reasonable with colleagues in the Parliament, and I've said to Mr Bibby on numerous occasions there will be time we'll be able to work together, and I'll be able to ensure that you will get a statement that you've requested, and there are times that I won't be able to do that. And I'll give the reasons on this case just further down the line, but I've tried to be reasonable, Presiding Officer, and I think just by Mr Kerr's intervention earlier on there, we see how difficult that job is when I am trying to be this reasonable, reasoned individual trying to work through the business that we've got in front of us here today. Because how can you deal when you're trying to be reasonable with someone who is just constantly showboating and just playing for the gallery all the time? It is impossible to deal with that. What I will say, Presiding Officer, on COVID certification and how it works is extremely important, and it's my position that we've had the opportunity to debate, question and discuss. And if surely if we can forget the theatrics at the moment, Presiding Officer, and we can possibly move on to the reasons why I actually believe that they've had ample time. We have had a topical question on the issue last week. We have had COVID state of which the First Minister has stood on her feet for the past 2 weeks for 2 hours and answered questions to every single individual who has asked it regarding COVID. During that period, we have actually had opposition members, Presiding Officer. This may shock you. Opposition members on this issue that I was told at Bureau was one of the most important issues that had to be debated and had to be discussed. 5 opposition members asked questions about it. So the First Minister's on her feet for 2 hours over the past 2 weeks. There has been a topical question on it. And to add to that, the Deputy First Minister attends the COVID committee every 2 weeks. So let's revise this again, Presiding Officer. Apart from topical question, 2 hours of COVID-19 statement, the Deputy First Minister attending the COVID-19 committee every 2 weeks, I don't think there's much more we can do. I have to ask, you know, if Mr Kerr feels there's not time for scrutiny of the government, it's not my fault that he's not good at the actual thing itself. He has to ensure that he gets his act together. So, Presiding Officer, I would just like to say the Scottish Parliament has already had a full debate on this issue, and during that debate, the Parliament actually said that they would actually go forward with this. But let's look at this. The whole point is ministers must review the regulations at least every 3 weeks to assess whether any requirement in the regulations is still necessary to protect against control
Colleagues,
or deprive a public health response.
Mr Adam.
Yes.
I am concerned that all colleagues in the chamber cannot hear your contribution. I would be grateful if we could hear Mr Adam. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. In closing, I was just trying to say that as soon as the ministers consider the requirements no longer to be necessary to this purpose, they must be revoked. The devolved position will be that the certification regulations are due to expire on the 28th of February 2022. Presiding Officer, in closing, all I can say is, you know, our place here is to actually scrutinise, to be part of government, come up to solutions, not actually play pantomime season before it is Christmas.
The question is that Amendment 1328.1 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote and there will be a short suspension to allow access to the digital voting system.